Not sure, but I'm going to read this anyhow. Good morning, everyone. This is our annual retreat church on North Allen in Tallmadge, Ohio. Broadcasting via FM radio 93.7, also live streaming via our parish Facebook page. We're about to begin the celebration of the 8:30 a.m. Mass for the baptism of the Lord. A reminder to anyone who may be praying with us in the parking lot. In communion time, the minister will come out to the covered walkway to distribute communion to anyone praying with us. At that time, please come forward to receive communion and kindly return to your vehicle for the remainder of this celebration. For any unable to come forward once those who are able have done so, then please drive up to the covered walkway, and a minister will bring communion to you while you are in your vehicle. Again, then simply return to your spot in the parking lot for the remainder of this celebration. Thank you, and we will begin shortly. Morning. The entrance chant, I don't have any numbers up. We're going to sing 114 in our 15th grade. Call Jesus to Jordan's waters.
We come together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we gather on this baptism of the Lord. We call to mind our own baptism, the time that we were incorporated not only into the body of Christ, but we were made beautiful once again. For the times we have sinned, we call these to mind, and so prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace.
Chosen one with whom I am pleased. lamps will wait for his teaching. I, the Lord, have called you for the victory of justice. I have grasped you by the hand and formed you and set you as a covenant of the people, a light for the nations, to open the eyes of the blind, to bring out prisoners from confinement and from the dungeon, those who live in darkness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. This is what he proclaimed. One mightier than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop and loosen the thongs of his sandals. I have baptized you with water. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. It happened in those days that Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized in the Jordan by John. On coming out of the water, he saw the heavens being torn open, and the Spirit, like a dove, descending upon him. And a voice came from the heavens, "You are my beloved Son. With you I am well pleased." The Gospel of the Lord. This past summer, when I was out walking on the beach one day, there was a large crowd, and there was a great kind of commotion that was going on over down near the water. And so as I approached, I saw there was kind of like this canopy tent, and there was a banner, name of a church, if you will. And in the midst of the water, close to the shore, but in the midst of the water, there were two individuals, and there was a third one in the center, and they were baptizing. They were pushing people down into the water and lifting them up, and then the drum would beat, and I believe there was a trumpet and all sorts of noise and commotion and hallelujahs and praise God, and all that would happen, and that person would move out of the way, and then another one would be brought over. There was a point in time where I just wanted to go up and tap someone on the shoulder and say, "Do you need any kind of help? I have some knowledge about this." But it just struck me, you know, those natural elements. And then when we think about today, when we celebrate the baptism of the Lord, who didn't need baptized, absolutely didn't. I mean, he was the one that, so to speak, invented it. But how he immersed himself in the dirty waters of a river. For that matter, go back to when he was born, how he came into being and was given birth in a stable, a cave, or, you know, something that certainly didn't have bedding, didn't have light and warmth, didn't have hot water. Didn't seem to be a midwife, at least nothing's reported in the gospel. But he was kind of like born into the dirt of humanity. And isn't that where God is? The one who didn't say, "Well, you know, I'm going to wait until they get their act together. I want everybody to be cleaned up, and I want them to be in their wedding garment that day. Because when I come into this world, I just really want it to be nice." No, he chose to come into the world when it wasn't nice. For that matter, he still chooses to come into the world, even though it's still not nice yet. But hopefully we're getting there. That's our God, who joins humanity not because we're perfect, but rather because we're imperfect. And he's here to help us with that. That's our God who joins humanity in all our weaknesses and our frailties, because he comes to help make us strong, make us powerful. Powerful at least in terms of conquering evil. That's the God, and that's the God who was the Beloved. This is the second epiphany of the Lord, a revelation of God in our midst. So I would suggest that perhaps day in and day out, there's probably still other epiphanies that you and I encounter in the most unexpected ways, where God makes known, "No, this is where I want you right now. This is where I'm going to reveal something more to myself and something more of you. So listen, take to heart, for you too are my beloved." By virtue of our baptism in Christ, we share in the mission and ministry of the Lord, called to share in Jesus' priestly, prophetic, and kingly ministry. Let us raise our voice in prayer this day and always.
That all who are baptized into the everlasting covenant may conquer the world by faith and transform it by love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations who do not yet know God's steadfast love may be moved by the witness of believers to seek and find the Lord, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those estranged from God and from the community may be guided to return to the God of compassion, love, and mercy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That victims of violence may be embraced by God's loving arms, and along with their families may be restored to wholeness one day, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That inquirers, along with catechumens and candidates, as well as candidates for confirmation in the Eucharist, may be led to a deeper relationship in Christ by the Spirit alive in our lives, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That men and women will be responsive to the call of the Lord to religious and ordained life, along with lay ministry in the church, and that those who serve the church in these vocations may continue to follow and model the Lord's life in faithfully carrying out his mission and ministry, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who give of their time and talent for the good of our church and the wider community may continue to be strengthened by Christ, who calls all of us to service, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we who have been baptized into Christ may go about doing and being instruments of healing to all, as we join with others to bring healing, peace, and unity to our homes, our communities, and our nation, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God's word, descending on us like winter snow and rain, may accomplish its purpose among us and yield a harvest of obedient faith and generous love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and suffering, especially Rebecca Carney, Kelly Castle, John Tartarina, Mary Dunkey, Danny Firth, Floss Firth, Daisha Furtney, Robert Jaggett, Julian Jenkins, Dan Lane, Tom Lorkowski, Beth Mariola, Lynn Mattingly, Judith Mullen, Kate Neglack, Ann Richards, Carol Scaley, George Silver Jr., Paula Simmons, Kaylin Tafini, Alex Tedrick, Giovanni Testa, Mary Testa, Tina Testa, as well as the victims and survivors of clergy sexual abuse in our church, may be restored to healing and wholeness, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And all the departed, especially those who have recently died, Peggy Baldwin, Mother of Kim Tuesday, Father Thomas G. Monovan, Madeline Strauss, as well as Dave Richard, for whom this Mass is being offered, and all who believe in Jesus as Christ may share fully in the victory by which Christ conquers death, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the intentions written in our prayer notebook, along with those that remain in our hearts and minds, as well as those we have been asked to pray for, may find favor with God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father of great and everlasting glory, by the power of your Holy Spirit, you have consecrated your word made flesh and have established this Christ, our Savior, as your covenant of peace for all peoples. As we celebrate today the mystery of Jesus' baptism in the River Jordan, renew in us our own baptism. Pattern our lives on this Christ, your chosen one, the child on whom your favor rests, the beloved with whom you are well pleased, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Our offertory chant in the Breaking Bread book chorus. Let's sing number 57, Christ Circle Round.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of your hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the offerings we have brought to honor the revealing of your beloved Son, so that the oblation of your faithful may be transformed into the sacrifice of him who willed in his compassion to wash away the sins of the world, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord. Servant has been anointed with the oil of gladness. praise, Father most holy, for you are great, and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death, for you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior, made incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, and to the sorrowful heart of joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by me, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer. especially your servant Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation, free from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
sing the hymn Bread of Life, and it's number 73 in our break.
Bread of
Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly entreat your mercy, O Lord, that faithfully listening to your only begotten Son, we may be your children in name and in truth.